you're sitting around and you have nowhere to go. No, you don't. Come on in. Welcome to the Cranky Show.
A metalizer on the engine part. Come on. Which is also rattle canned. And then we come in and we normally, because we worry about the finish, we use the airbrush, because the airbrush will often lay down a very thin coat of paint, and you can regulate how much paint and all of that. So, you know, if finish is important to you, you are in fact going to get a very good finish with rattle cans, no doubt. But if you're doing graphics, if you're doing some intense candy work, you could also get a lot of mileage out of your airbrush. So practice, and have all these things available to you. Practice both with the rattle can and practice both with the airbrush or airbrushes, as the case may be. So, you know, you once you do that, it seems to me that you'll be well-versed in both, and you will always use both, no big deal. And you practice back and forth. So it's the thing that you never forget. You know, once you get comfortable with the airbrush, it's the same thing with rattle cans. You go through that quick learning curve where you destroy a few models at first, you get orange peel, you get this, you get that. Then you start getting better and better and better, and you gain your confidence. And next thing you know, you're ready to move on to the airbrush, and the same process starts all over again. But, you know, what works for us is we always do both. And so we never forget. We always are practiced almost every day. There's a little bit of practice that goes on, even when we're not spraying real paint. You know, sometimes I just to check the flow and functionality of the airbrush, I will load it up with water or Windex or what have you, and then in front of a light, I shoot it at different PSIs to see how the machine is working. So airbrushes require a lot of maintenance because they're expensive tools and you want to take care of them. Whereas with rattle cans, as you use them, you empty them, you throw them out. My recommendation always also is don't get suckered into buying a substandard airbrush that comes with those canned air cans that you connect, because those things are going to be very expensive. So while you're rattle canning, this is good advice for most of you starting out, start saving some money. You know, get yourself a little piggy bank and start putting in all your loose change. Begin at the beginning, let's say in January, and start saving money. By the end of the year, I am pretty sure you will have enough money in that piggy bank to be able to afford either an airbrush / compressor set or one of the other. My advice is to get, you know, the airbrush. That way you can start practicing even without running any air to it. Get the compressor, you know, either one, and get the kind of tool that's going to serve you well for many, many years. So that's a long ways to go to answer CT's question this morning, but we wanted to do it because it's a question that, you know, for us, we still work with both. So in a way, it doesn't have an answer. These are things that you will always have in your, paint rattle cans. You'll always have those. And then once you get going on the airbrush, you'll have one, and then two, and then three. Then when you have eight or 10 or however many, then you can start designating them for particular uses. I have one for clears, I have one for metalizers, the micron is always for extreme detail, all of that stuff. But we clean them well, and so with every cleaning, it resets itself. So let's say you've been using metalizer paints or flakes with one airbrush. Well, if you clean it really, really well and maintain it, that airbrush is good to go with any kind of fluid you're going to put through it. So we switch between acrylics, enamels, and urethanes all the time here in the laboratory without any problem. So You could also, decant the paint from a rattle can and then use it in the airbrush, or what we do with nail polish, which is that we mix it with cheap lacquer and then we shoot that. So anyway, it looks like this video might end up being a two-part video just because the camera has been rolling and we're heading towards 12 minutes here. Keep that in mind. Do not stress yourself out over any of this, please. It's a slow process. It's going to test your patience. It's a hobby that you're starting up again or starting in for the first time, and it's going to be a lifelong endeavor. So don't drive yourself crazy. You have a lot of time to learn, and you also have to keep in mind that perfection, which is illusory, it's never going to be perfect. You have to remember that. It's just never going to, you're going to get really good. You're going to get good. You're going to win prizes if that's what you want. You're going to make people's jaws drop and their eyes pop out of their skulls, all fine and dandy. But you will never be the world's greatest model builder, and you will never achieve perfection. So once you settle on those big concepts, then you scale back down to human, to a human level, and you say, you know what, this is a fun hobby. I'm going to enjoy it for the duration of my life, and that's it. But if you have a competitive spirit and you have a big ego, and you think for 1 minute that you're going to walk onto a world stage with your models and say, hey, look at me, I'm God's gift to this hobby, watch out, because when you look back over your shoulder, you're going to see a pretty long line of model builders with the same accomplishments and who might be better or worse than you. But anyway, that's a completely different talk, start slow and go from there, but inform yourself, read up, whenever you're not building models, look around the forums, ask questions, see what others are doing, and you're going to see, how much fun you're going to have. So, anyway, again, thanks CT for getting us, ranting, so early in the morning. But we'll be back. We'll be back with more Cranky Show, my friends. So stay tuned in. We still have a lot of April to go, and we still have a little bit of May to go. So, and we still have to finish a very important build that just arrived here in the Lab-RAT-ory. So Dr. Cranky here saying goodbye. Feed your styrene addiction, my friends. All right.